ബ്രുക്ലിൻ ക്വീൻസ് ലോങ് ഐലൻഡ് അവതരിപ്പിക്കുന്നു ഒരേകാംഗ നാടകം ഡിയർ ചാർലി. ഇതിൽ അഭിനയിക്കുന്ന നടീനടന്മാരെ ഒന്ന് പരിചയപ്പെടുത്തിക്കോട്ടെ. ഡാനിയോ എരിമേലിക്കര, നിഷി കൊടിയൻ താറ, ശ്രുതി ജെയ്ക്ക് ആൻഡ് ജ്യോതിസ് കുടിലിൽ, എഡ്വിൻ ജസ്ലൻ ആൻഡ് രഞ്ജു പെരുമ്പലത്ത്, ആഞ്ചലീന ആൻഡ് സ്മിത തോട്ടം, ജെയ്ഡൻ ഊരാളിൽ, ആൻഡ് ലൈറ്റിംഗ് ബൈ ടോസിൻ പെരുമ്പലത്ത്. Without further ado, we present Dear Charlie, a one-act drama devised and directed by Carol Maruvancheri.
I am not going to school.
You're being so unoriginal.
I don't care. I refuse.
Oh, you refuse. That's hilarious. When did you become so dramatic?
You can't make me.
You're right. I can't. But Gran can.
Charlie.
And definitely will.
This is so unfair.
Charlie, where is your backpack? Did I not ask you to be ready on time? Was I not clear?
I don't want to go to school.
Speak up, Charlie. You know I can't stand mumbling.
I don't want to go to school.
Don't be ridiculous. Enough is enough. All children go to school and that's that.
But I...
That's enough, Charlie. Off we go.
I will be writing to Alan about this.
Of course you should write to Alan. It's your first day of school. There'll be so much to tell him.
Charlie.
I love you, sweetheart.
Dear Alan, I am sorry to report that a grave injustice has happened to me. Gran is forcing me to attend St. Anthony's School, headed by Principal Higgins, an old, retired army vet. He is a man tied to his daily routine. He wakes up every morning at 5, puts on his suit and tie, and walks 2 blocks down to the school. On his way, he would stop by the local cafe to pick up a large coffee and the morning newspaper.
No milk, no sugar?
He is the type that likes their coffee black, simple, without any fuss. He then arrives at the school every morning at 5:45 sharp. Then he walks the hallways for 15 minutes, inspecting every crook and cranny. After which he goes to his office to put down his coffee and open up the morning newspaper. Alone in his office, with his thoughts and his newspaper, with no noisy children to disturb him. This is his favorite part of the day, for it is quiet and ordinary. Today, however, was anything but ordinary.
Mrs. Hayes, what brings you to my school so early?
Forgive my intrusion, Mr. Higgins, but I have someone new to enroll in your school.
No sooner was I standing on the old school grounds, staring at the cracked walls, when I was surrounded by my new classmates, who were curious to say the least.
Who are you? What's your name?
Where are you from?
Who's your parents?
Hello, Charlie. I am Principal Higgins. I wanted to welcome you to St. Anthony's School for well-behaved children, as well as to our little town. There will be time for chatting later. In the meantime, let's not delay, Larry. Kindly get to class.
Charlie, come on in. Class, we have a new student who will be joining us this term. Charlie, would you like to introduce yourself? Perhaps the class can introduce themselves to you.
Hi, Charlie. I'm Olivia.
Stan.
Julia.
Jack.
Victoria.
Escobar.
You have joined us just in time for the Personal Hero Project. Each week this semester, one student picks his person, living or dead, whom they identify to be their personal hero, and gives a small presentation And this week, it's Victoria's turn. Who will you be presenting, Victoria?
Elizabeth Taylor.
Well, come on up then. Your turn will be coming soon, Charlie. So be sure you pick someone, okay?
Next thing I know, I am treated to a 30-minute presentation about Elizabeth Taylor. Why?
Because she's the icon of glamour.
And I hear that Stan is presenting Rosa Parks.
Power to the people.
Julia is talking about her aunt.
She's just the best.
Olivia is presenting Einstein.
He's a genius, so it's only natural.
And Escobar is presenting on his dad.
He's the mayor, so watch it.
Meanwhile, I can't seem to care about anyone or anything. When are you coming to get me, Alan? I know you said you can't with your job, but maybe if you explain the circumstances, they may allow you just this once. Meanwhile, I just want to be left alone.
How was school? Did you make any friends?
What's up with the new kid?
He doesn't speak.
He's probably shy.
Or mute.
There's something fishy going on with him, and I don't like it.
Do you like your teacher?
I heard he got expelled from his last school.
I thought he was homeschooled.
Who's homeschooling him?
His mom, I assume.
So who is his mom?
I don't know. Has anyone seen her?
I've only seen his gran, Mrs. Hayes.
The wealthy lady who lives up the hill?
Apparently that mean old bat is his gran.
I asked you a question, Charlie.
I thought Mrs. Hayes lived alone.
So not anymore, I guess.
I didn't know she had children, nevertheless a grandson.
I've heard my parents say she had a daughter who lived out of town.
My dad says she was a huge troublemaker who left town when she was in high school.
And that's Charlie's mom?
Who else?
So why is she back now with Charlie?
She probably wants to be around now that Miss Hayes is so old, so she and Charlie can inherit her millions when she dies.
I am talking to you, Charlie.
I hate school, I hate this town, I hate my life, and I hate you!
Charlie!
I am sorry to hear you're finding it difficult to acclimate yourself to school and this town, but know that you are not the only one finding this change challenging. I almost forgot, there is a letter for you from Alan. And you will never speak to me in that tone as long as you live under my roof. Understood?
That was very unkind, kiddo. Your gran is tough. God, do I know. But she loves you, and I know you'll find that hard to believe. But you just have to take my word for it. We're in this together, remember?
Leave me alone.
Come on, Charlie.
Please.
Dear Charlie, I am sorry to hear you are having trouble fitting in at school, but that is only natural. After all, you are a new addition to an ensemble that shares years of previous history. In my experience, the more you can share yourself with others, the better likelihood others will understand and thus accept you. As for me coming to get you, I am sorry, Charlie, but as you already know, that is simply impossible at this time. In the meantime, I know you will be safe with Gran, and if you give her a chance, who knows, you may not want to leave her after all. Love, always, Alan.
My mom is a painter. I grew up sitting at her feet and watching her hands move over a blank canvas, filling it with the most vibrant colors. Her hands moved quickly over the canvas, unapologetically, covering it with what I can only describe as magic. She is magic. She is my hero. My dad is cool. His name is Alan, but he is never around because he is always working. All I have of him are these letters he sends me. And one day, after a particularly difficult day at school,
hey kiddo, how was school?
When will I get to see Alan?
I don't know. Whenever he completes his mission? Is that what he said?
Do you think he remembers me? He hasn't seen me since I was 5.
Of course he remembers you, Charlie. Your dad loves you.
Alan.
Yes, Alan loves you very much. And if you really miss him, tell him the next time you write to him.
I did. and he said he's coming to visit me on my birthday.
He said what?
He said he's gonna take me to the movies and then go ice skating.
You don't know how to ice skate.
Alan said he will teach me.
Oh, did he now?
Yeah. You don't believe me?
You're not going ice skating with Alan.
Why not?
Because he isn't coming.
He is coming. He told me.
I don't want to talk about this anymore.
You never want to talk about Dad.
Why are you lying to me, Charlie?
I'm not lying.
That's enough, Charlie. We do not lie to each other, ever. Alan is not coming, and he never told you he is coming. Why are you doing this? Did something happen at school? Did someone say something? Look at me, Charlie. Charlie, look at me when I am talking to you.
Mom! I remember floating, flashing lights, sirens echoing, and unfamiliar voices all around me. I remember a chilly autumn evening, and it was raining. A small group of people, dressed in black, stood while they watched a closed casket being lowered into the ground.
I'm here, Charlie. I'm here.
Hello, Charlie. I'm your grand, and you are going to live with me now. I look forward to us getting to know each other.
Take Grand's hand, Charlie. Go on. I'm here.
Come on, Charlie.
Thank you for sharing that with us, Charlie. I don't know if you know this, but your mom and I grew up together. We were good friends. Practically spent every day together. Before she left town, a different time. All right, class, how about we take our lunch a little early and we will continue with history after.
I'm so sorry to hear about your mom, Charlie.
When did she pass away?
About 3 months ago.
Where's your dad?
He works for the government, so I don't see him a lot.
So is that why you live with your grandma?
What does your dad do?
He works for intelligence.
Like the CIA?
Yeah.
So that's so cool.
Where's he stationed?
I don't know. He's not supposed to say.
Wow, I can't believe your dad is a spy.
Because he isn't.
Escobar.
What? We're all supposed to believe the new kid's dad is James Bond?
I didn't say my dad was James Bond. I said he works in intelligence.
Says who?
Says my dad.
If your dad's a spy, then he won't be allowed to tell you he's a spy. That's just basic espionage 101.
I think that's only in the movies.
Movies are based on life. Life imitates art, remember?
I think it's the other way around.
The point is, if you're a spy, then you can't say you're a spy. Otherwise, bad guys will find you and kidnap their loved ones in order to get to them. It's basically the plot of every spy movie.
How awful. I hope you don't get kidnapped, Charlie.
He won't, because his dad's not a spy.
Yes, he is. I can prove it.
What's that supposed to be?
A letter from my dad. And look at the address.
Alan Smith, Central Intelligence.
See, he wasn't lying.
There is no Central Intelligence Office.
What? Of course there is.
Not from Leveland. This mail was posted from Leveland.
That's where the office is. Although, he isn't there. That's just...
Leveland is the town next door. It's even smaller than this town, and so we share the same post office.
It's actually 5 minutes down the main road. You probably passed her on the way into town.
Have you ever seen your dad?
Yes.
When?
I can't remember.
How do you not even remember when you saw your dad?
When I was 4.
Then you don't remember.
You don't know my dad.
As it turns out, you don't either.
You're wrong!
Dear Charlie, I'm sorry to hear you're having trouble fitting in at school, but that is only natural. After all, you are a new addition to an ensemble that shares years of previous history and background. In my experience, the more you can share yourself with others, the better likelihood they will accept you. As for me coming
against
you,
it's not real. None of it is real.
Charlie, what's wrong?
Charlie, what are you doing? Will you look at this mess?
Where is my dad?
What are you talking about?
What happened?
Why isn't he here?
Because he has an important job, you know this.
In Loveland?
What happened at school?
What about Loveland?
It's not real. None of it is real.
I'm so sorry, Charlie.
Charlie, what's going on with you?
Who wrote these?
Charlie, you have to understand.
They are Alan's letters, your dad.
Stop lying. I want to know. I just want to know.
I'm so sorry.
Your dad writes...
You're lying!
Charlie!
Charlie, come back!
Charlie! Charlie, I have made a terrible mistake.
Mrs. Hayes?
Charlie has run off.
In this rain?
I can't find him.
Which way did he go?
I can't find him.
Evelyn, you have to calm down. We will find him.
I have made a terrible mistake.
Miss Good, kindly take Mrs. Hayes home. Yeah?
Yeah. Come, Mrs. Hayes.
I've made a terrible mistake.
Don't worry, Evelyn. It's a small town. He can't have gone far. We will find him.
I have made a terrible mistake. Charlie. Charlie.
Charlie, don't you hear them calling out your name? They will never find you in this night if you don't answer. Please, kiddo, wake up. Here, I'll help you.
There's a flashing light coming from the forest.
It could be Charlie.
Charlie, oh, thank you, thank you. Your mother left the house the day she turned 18. I tried to stop her, but I quickly realized I had no power over her. In my attempt to give her everything, I forgot to give her the most important thing, love. So she found it somewhere else and chased it, leaving everything and everyone behind. I stood on the sidelines, brokenhearted, as I watched my child lose everything, including the young man she loved. Long before you were even born. And when you were born, I tried to reach out, help her, but she wouldn't let me. She said I didn't know how to love and that her child deserved to be loved. She was punishing me. All that said, she still needed money, and you started to ask questions. So I started to send her a check once a month with a letter attached. It was her idea to write to you as Alan in order to fill a void you may have, as well as for me to be in touch with you. It wasn't meant to go on forever, just until you were old enough to understand. But the heart wallows in pain and is resistant to check second chances. And before any of it can be mended, she was gone. I know you must feel lost and betrayed, Charlie. But the one thing you must know is that you are loved. Alan may not be the person you thought you were, but Alan loves you, has always loved you. Alan is my middle name, my father's name. Alan is me, and I have loved you from the very beginning.
Why are you so mad with Gran?
Because when you were born, I finally understood what love was, what it meant to love someone unconditionally. And knowing that almost made me wonder why I was never able to feel my mother's love and question if she loved me at all. So I did everything I could to make my baby feel loved. I never wanted you to doubt it, you see? But my failings and resentment kept you from someone else who also loved you as dearly. And for that, I am sorry.
Does this mean you're gonna leave or move on?
Those we love are never lost, Charlie. We carry them in our hearts, and they are reflected in everything we do.
Charlie, let's not be late for school. Would you look at that? It's snowing. Charlie, what's wrong? Don't you want to go to school? I thought you made friends with everyone.
It's not that. I don't want to call you Gran.
Oh, what would you like to call me instead?
Alan.
Alan sounds nice.
Hey, Alan, can we go ice skating?
Do you know how to ice skate?
No.
Well, you are in luck, because I happen to be an excellent skater. I'll teach you.
Dear Charlie, live boldly.
Dear Charlie, love fiercely.
Dear Charlie, what is stronger than the human heart, which shatters over and over again and continues living? Live, Charlie, live.